Hello everyone. So let's start today's class. In the last class, I have given the formulas of waves, till beats, and I told you, you make that chart which I have given in the notes, that is waxing and waning of tuning fork, how the frequency is changing and which formula we have to use. That table I told you draw. Nobody did that also. Whatever I have given, that many formulas only you have written. Next, I told Doppler effect all cases, you have to write formulas when source is stationary, source is moving, when both are moving, in which direction, how to use sign conventions. Then if moving target is there, circular loop is there, then object is or observer is outside the circle, inside the circle, everything. Whatever cases I have given, car and observer and all, when they are not in the same line, all that formulas you have to write. Okay, this is first point. See the notebook and complete first that all formulae. Okay, next, I have sent, I think, almost 54 or 45 problems, I don't know. Yes, but that problems, one or two students have solved. That's it. Nobody has asked doubt. Nobody has sent any question that, sir, I did not understand this and all. So it is very wrong. You are not responding. So you have to respond first. Okay. So I am starting now problem solving from reverse so that you will understand. And at least now, those who have solved, you can just see. Those who did not solve, at least start now, try to solve, use your notebook, revise one, because every year almost 14 to 15 questions are coming in JEE mains from this chapter, not in one paper, means particularly complete all sessions, we can say. So almost in every session you are getting one question from webs. Got it? Last year I think 23 questions. So this is very important chapter, and if you will not solve problems, then you will be in trouble. Keep it in mind. If you have doubt, send me that question. Okay? So those who did not solve single question also, let me start from Doppler effect, which I have given assignment. Because as we have finished Doppler effect last, so let's start from Doppler effect. Doppler effect problems. Okay. Right. So let's start from the first problem which I have given you. Yes, here, this is what the first question on this Doppler effect which I have given to you. Right? So let's see how to solve this problem. Okay. Now, listen carefully. Try to solve yourself. The speed at which a source of sound should move so that a stationary observer finds the apparent frequency equal to 11 by 12th of original frequency. So here it is, n apparent is equal to 11 by 12 n naught. Okay. Now if you will see here, this you will get something around n apparent is equal to 11 by 12 means less than 1. Yes or not? Isn't it? 11 by 12. How much you are getting? Is is coming 0.916 into n naught. That implies what? N apparent is definitely less than n naught. Means actual frequency. N apparent is less than n naught. So as apparent frequency is less than the actual one, what we can conclude? We can conclude that if this is the observer, then source must go away. Then only frequency will be less. So this is what? Source is going away. Source is going away. So if this is the source velocity, Ps, which we have to find, Ps is equal to question mark, and sound velocity is what here? P. P is what? Sound velocity. So you see, already we have learned so many cases, and out of that is what? Source is going away, and this is a stationary observer. Stationary observer. So in this case, what is the formula? N apparent is equal to N naught into P divided by P plus Ps. Isn't it? Yes, N apparent is equal to what? N naught P by V plus Ps. Now substitute all the values. N apparent value is what? You have 11 by 12 N naught is equal to N naught into bracket P by V plus Ps. This N naught will get cancelled. Cross multiplication you do. 11 into or 11 by 12 P plus Ps is equal to P. And solve this, you will get answer as Ps is equal to P by how much here? P by 11. Yes or not? P by 11. Check it and do it yourself at least now. I have given everything guideline. Just you have to substitute the values. At least do it from here. 11 by 12 V plus 11 by 12 Vs. Then transfer this term that side and get the value of Ps. That is what? The speed at which a source of sound should be moved. Understood? Pause the video. Take little break. Means 2 minutes. And solve within that 2 minutes. And complete this question and then go for next slide. Got it? So pause the video and do it yourself. Okay, next. Now, let's see the next question. What was the next question? See here. Yes, this is the second question. See here, how to solve this? A whistling engine is approaching a stationary observer. So you see here, if this is an engine, yes, and assume karo it is having whistle, it is approaching a stationary observer. This is Vs, velocity of source, and this is the observer which is at stationary. It is coming towards this. And this source velocity is given. how much it is given? Observed velocity 110 meter per second. Okay, and velocity of sound also given. P is equal to 330 meter per second. The ratio of frequencies as heard by the observer as the engine approaches and recedes away. Now same engine is going away. Yes or not? Like this. In this case, it is recedes away. Recedes away means goes away. Recedes away. Okay, or recedes. Only recedes also you can write. Recedes. And this is coming towards. Now, the first case, in this case, source is coming towards the observer. So, N apparent will be more. So, what is the formula? N naught P by P minus ES. Okay. And in this case, N apparent dash is equal to what? N naught into V by V plus S. ES. Enough. You know the trick. What is that trick? You see, each train is going away. Frequency will be less. And that's why denominator will be big. That's why plus sign. Here you see, train is coming towards the observer. It means what? Frequency is more. That's why denominator here, this should be less. And therefore, it is minus. Like this, you keep it in mind. Now, what he is asking? Ratio of that frequency he is asking. So if I am doing like this, N apparent divided by N apparent dash is equal to N naught into V by P minus S divided by N naught into V by P plus S. This cancels, this cancels, this will go up, and that is nothing but V plus S by P minus S. What you are getting? P plus Ps by P minus Ps. And as you know the values, you can substitute now here. What is V? 330 plus Ps is how much? 110 divided by 330 minus 110. This is equal to 440 divided by how much? 220. And this is nothing but how much? 2 as to 1. And therefore, N apparent as to N apparent dash is equal to what? 2 as to 1. And hence, I think this option is the right. Check it once. Okay? Understood? Do it yourself. And solve it. Pause the video. Do it yourself. So next question is what and how. Let's do it. The next question is like this, which I have given already. So many of have not solved it. Try to solve it. Otherwise, it will be difficult for you. So this is what question. Next question you can see. Okay. So see here. This is question number. Next, whatever I have given in the assignment which I have sent you, no problem. So let's see how to solve this. How to solve this question. Now see, there are two aeroplanes A and B which are moving away from one another with a speed of 720 km per hour. Both are having same speed. Keep it in mind. So I am trying to draw one rough diagram. You see here, this is a plane, something like this. You try to understand, although it looks like a blue whale, but this is a plane, okay? Isn't it right? Something like this. And okay, ऐसे करेंगे तो ताकि थोड़ा सा प्लेन की तरह लगी है ना. And this is another plane. Not like this. Okay. Or something like this. Not a. Or okay. Or something like this. Now this is moving here and this is moving here. Both are having same velocity. How much that is? 720 kilometer per hour. Both are going away. Here also how much it is? 720 kilometer per hour. Okay. So here in this case, you see. The frequency of the whistle emitted by A is 1100 hertz. If suppose this is A, this is a B, and they have given n is equal to how much? 1100 hertz. The apparent frequency of the whistle as heard by the passenger of the aeroplane B is. So, this passenger who is in the plane B, what velocity sound he will receive or he will appear to be? Received, okay. That is what we have to find. And they have given velocity of sound. You have to take 350 meter per second. So before going forward, first you convert this 720 kilometer per hour is equal to 720 into 5/18 meter per second. Okay. What I am doing? This I am converting into meter per second. So this is coming 40, and this is how much? 200 meter per second. Right? So we got PS value. Now in this case, as both are moving, so here one is source and one is observer. Here it is observer. We can say this is the observer. And this is a source. Both are in motion. See here, although this is a VS, although this is a VS, but those which are passenger inside this, that is what? P0 value we can say. Passenger also moving with the same speed. Therefore, this is also equal to how much? 200 meter per second. So let's use the formula. What is the formula? N0 P minus PS divided by P plus P naught. Then this is equal to P minus V naught by P plus V naught into N naught. Because VS is equal to V naught. So therefore, what we are getting now, let's substitute the values. Yes. So N apparent, do you have N apparent? No, we don't have N apparent. We have to find that. So N apparent is equal to N naught is how much here? It is given 1100. So substitute this into P how much? 350 minus 200 divided by 350 plus 200. If you will solve this, how much you are getting? 1100 into 350 minus 200, 150 divided by 550. Check it. And this twos are. So answer is how much you are getting? 300 hertz. Na? How much? 150 into 2 is how much? 300 hertz. So I think option 1 is the right answer. Check it. So do it yourself. Don't see here. Try to do yourself and solve yourself. Okay. pause the video and note down. Next. Yes, here this is the next question which I have given. So see how to solve this. An engine is moving on a circular path of radius 100 meter with a speed of 20 meter per second. This is what now you see here. This is a, we have learned one case. Now you can use the notebook. This is the source which is moving. Yes. Is the sound waves. Source is moving and at the center, observer is here. Okay, observer is how? Stationary, and it is at center. When the engine blows the whistle of frequency, you know this, the frequency of N is how much here? That is, engine is how much? 500 hertz. Then the observer standing stationary at the center will hear the frequency of sound. Already you know, in this case, there is no Doppler effect. What is the case? No Doppler effect in this case. And therefore, N dash is equal to N naught, which is equal to 500 hertz. And therefore, option number 3, that is 500 hertz, is the answer. Yes or not? In this case, there is no Doppler effect. Next. Yes, this is your next question. What is the question? C. The frequency of a radar is 780 megahertz. Okay. And the frequency of reflected wave from an aeroplane is increased by 2.6 kilohertz. The velocity of aeroplane is. Yes or not? That is what he is asking. तो कैसे सॉल्व करेंगे? लेट्स सी. तो गिवन इज व्हाट? फ्रीक्वेंसी इज गिवन. सो एन नॉट इज इक्वल टू 780 मेगाहर्ट्ज. दैट इज इक्वल टू 780 इनटू 10 टू द पावर 6 हर्ट्ज, बिकॉज़ 1 मेगाहर्ट्ज इज इक्वल टू 10 पावर 6 हर्ट्ज. यू नो दिस. नाउ एरोप्लेन इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय मींस डेल्टा एन. Yes or not? Delta N means you can say beats also. Delta N is equal to how much? 2.6 kilohertz. So that is equal to 2.6 into 10 to the power 3 hertz. Okay. And the velocity of aeroplane he is asking means he is asking you velocity of source is equal to how much. So in this case of microwave, we have learned one formula for beats. That is what delta N is equal to 2 into PS divided by C. C is what? Velocity of light into N naught. So delta N you have, N naught you have, C you know. Just use it and do it yourself. Can you do it? Wait, I will substitute and give you so that you can do more easily. So 10 power 3 is equal to 2 into PS value we don't know. C value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 and N naught is how much? 780 into 10 to the power 6. This 8 will get cancelled with this and here it is left 10 power 2, right? And if I will cancel this 100 with this, you are getting something 7.8. So solve this from here now. So this is 2.6 into 3 into 10 to the power 3 divided by into 7.8 is equal to PS. Read this. How much are getting? Check it. What is the answer? 0.5 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to PS, and therefore in this box I am writing, this is nothing but how much? This is 500 meter per second is equal to PS. As options are in kilometer per second, you can convert, or as it is, what is that? 0.5 kilometer per second, and therefore option number 3 is the right answer. Yes, or this or this, anything you can do it, but here options are in kilometer per second, that's why I have converted into kilometer per second. Okay, next question was like this. Yes, this is the question. An observer moves towards a stationary source of sound with a velocity 1/5 of velocity of sound. So first, when you are reading the question, first make one rough diagram so that you will understand which formula you have to use. That is the first method of solving problem, we can say. So see, here an observer moves towards stationary source. Matlab, here observer is in motion, source is at rest. Okay. And this is, observer is moving with some velocity V naught. And this V naught is given as 1/5 of velocity of sound. Okay, this is what? Stationary source, PS is equal to 0. And he is asking percentage increase in apparent frequency. So, sabse pehle kya karenge? N apparent in this case, we have to use. Observer is in motion, source is at rest. Observer is in motion, source at rest. So kya formula hai? N is N naught into V plus V naught divided by P. We know this. Yes or not? So N apparent is equal to N naught into P plus V naught value is what? V by pi divided by V. That is equal to what? N naught into 6/5. Yes, what you are getting? 6/5. If you will do this, 5V plus V by 5 and down V cancel, you will get 6/5. This is N apparent. Now, percentage increase in apparent frequency. So, delta N is equal to what? N apparent minus N. Yes. And percentage increase means what? You are having delta N by N into 100. So that is equal to N apparent minus N divided by N into 100. So let's substitute the values. N apparent, how much you got? 6/5 N naught minus N naught divided by N naught is into 100. So do this now. How much you are getting? You are getting 1/5, है ना? यहाँ पे क्या आ जाएगा? If I am taking n naught common from here, this is 6/5 minus 1 divided by n naught. If I will cancel this into 100, I am getting 1/5. That's it. 1/5 into 100. So 1/5 into 100 means what you are getting here? 1/5 into 100. So this is how much? 0.2 into 100, and therefore that is equal to how much? 20%. Yes or not? What is the answer is percentage increase is 20%. Isn't it right? Now, next question. Next question was something like this. These are the options you can see. So this is the question, and let's see how to solve this. Okay. A train is moving at 30 meter per second in still air. The frequency of the locomotive is 500 hertz and the speed of sound is 345 meter per second. The apparent wavelengths of sound in front of and behind the locomotive are respectively. Ab kaise solve karenge isko? Yes, it seems to be little bit difficult, but it is very very easy. You see, in the notes I have given one column, apparent frequency and apparent wavelength, isn't it? I have given that formula, you can go through that. So see here, when train is approaching, when train approaches, lambda dash is equal to what? V minus Vs by N. And when train goes away, train goes away, then lambda double dash is what here? P plus Ps divided by N. This formula we know. Okay, apparent wavelength formulas. Now, we are having all the values. A train is moving at 30 meter per second. Yes. So, in first case, use that. Even in second case also, you can use it and see what you are getting when wavelength. So I am substituting for this. P is how much? P45 minus 30 divided by N is how much here? 500. Check it. In this case, 345 plus 30 divided by again 500. Now check these values, how much you are getting. Do it yourself and you will get the answers. Do it now. This is coming 0.63 meter. That is first one when train is approaching. And second one is coming 345 plus 30. Divided by 500. Obviously, it will come little more. So this is how much? 0.75 meter. That's it. So what is the option? I think second option is the right answer. Yes. So check it. Do it yourself. And whatever I have given in the notes, that formula, use it. Where you have to use which formula. Get practice. Okay. So next. Now next problem is something like this. Okay. Yes, this is your next question. Okay. If the velocity of sound in air is 300 meter per second, then there are options. First option is n1 is equal to 10 n. What is the first option? First option is like this. I am writing here or typing. N dash. I am writing like this. N dash is equal to 10 n. Second option, N dash is equal to 0. N dash is equal to 0. Third option, N dash is equal to 0.1 N. That is 0.1. And fourth option, -0.1 n. N dash is equal to -0.1 n. This is what your option. Okay, clear? So let's see how to solve this. Got it? Is the question. A vehicle with a horn of frequency n is moving with a velocity of 13 meter per second in a direction perpendicular to the straight line joining the observer and the vehicle. The observer perceives the sound to have a frequency if the velocity of sound in air is 300 meter per second. Then, now it is very, although it looks very big question, but you see, if there is already I have given one note point, if they are moving perpendicular, then there is no Doppler effect. No Doppler effect. Understand? And here n dash is equal to what? 0. N dash is equal to what? 0. Right? Yes, clear? So you are having this as the answer. Next one, next question. See here, this is the question. A source of sound is traveling towards tested observer. Now again, same model you are getting, which we have already solved. Towards the stationary observer. So n apparent in this case is equal to 25% more means what? I am writing like this, n naught initial plus 25% extra. This is an apparent. If the speed of sound is V, that of source is. It means PS is equal to what he is asking. So now as source is coming towards the observer, what is the formula for n apparent in this case? N apparent is equal to P by P minus S into N naught. Yes, this is the formula we are having. So here N apparent is equal to this. So I am writing like this, N naught plus 25 by 100 N naught is equal to P by P minus S into N naught. Now this is what? 1 by 4. So if I am taking n naught common from this, I am getting here how much? 1 plus 1 by 4. 1 plus 1 by 4 means how much you are getting? 5 by 4. Yes or not? And this is equal to P by V minus Ps into n naught. So this n naught and this n naught will get cancelled, cross multiplication. So 5V minus 5Vs divided by 4 divided by 4 is equal to P, and I want Vs value. So this term I am transferring here, minus 5 Vs divided by 4 is equal to P minus 5 V by 4. If you will do this, then minus 5 Vs by 4 is equal to minus V by 4 you are getting, because this is nothing but 1, 4 minus 5 V, minus V by 4 you are getting. This 4 and this 4, minus minus will get cancelled, and you are getting Vs is equal to V by 5. Yes, this should be the answer. So I think option number 1 is the right answer. Check it. Yes, so this is what the question is. Now, next question. This is the next question. And what is given here? A truck blowing horn of frequency 500 hertz travels towards a vertical mountain. Okay, so here it is a truck. Something like this. And here it is a mountain. Okay, this is a truck, and here is a mountain. So any obstacle I am taking like this. So according to the image thing, if we will take its image and this is going towards this, so here in such a type of cases you are having n apparent is equal to what? N into V plus V naught by V minus S, because one will receive reflected sound and one will feel that it is coming towards it, right or wrong. So it is like mirror image of the sources. You have to assume that it is here behind the mountain. So now everything you are having, let's substitute the values. N is what here? N is what here? 500 hertz, n apparent is 600. So what I am doing, I am substituting here like this. This is 600 is equal to 500 is 340 plus, okay, they have not given P naught, right, divided by P already given, that is how much? 340. So here it is 340 minus, as this is both are same, so that's why I'm writing here also V naught, because I want to find only V naught one. Okay. So if you will solve this, now try to solve yourself. 6/5 is equal to 340 plus V naught divided by 340 minus V naught. Solve this. If you will solve, you will get P naught is equal to 30.9, so therefore, which is nearly equal to 31 meter per second. Do it yourself. Pause the video and try. Just use formula and do it. Very, very simple problems are there, but try to revise the formulas. Write down Doppler effect all cases. So this is what some problems I have solved on Doppler effect. Please don't neglect it, right? And write down formulas with all tables. Very, very important. Okay. So let's stop here for today. Bye and good night.